Today is the day. The great YouTuber race is about to get started. First, allow me to explain what this race actually is. This is the EWS100. EWS stands for Enduro World Series. Now, the 100 means we're doing 100% of the course that the pros are riding. This year, it's a two-day event. Today is the easy day compared to what tomorrow will be. We are riding top of the world all the way down to the bottom. It's a 25-minute long stage. This will be the longest I've ever ridden without stopping on a mountain bike for me. So that is what me and six other mountain bike YouTubers are racing today. Please allow me to introduce you to the YouTuber crew that I am racing against here. Eric, who is BCPOV. Brian, who is BKXC. Ryan, who is the Lone Ranger. Josh, the Daily Mountain Bike Rider. Paul, the Punter. And Nick, who is VanCamp. Now, I only got my new Evolve Alpha 27 4 days before this race started. Now, that causes some anxiety and stress for me, knowing that I need to make sure my bike is dialed and that I understand all of how it works before the race starts. Not to mention just getting used to a whole nother bike again. Now, combine that with the fact that today started out terribly for me. There was a lot of stress. I was so rushed. I had to drive 2.5 hours up to Whistler. There was no time to relax and mentally prepare for the race. I finally met up with our crew before we were heading to the peak chair. At this point, I finally felt I could relax and just breathe a minute. I am feeling a bit nervous, and I feel some pressure on the stage for me to perform well. I do believe I have an advantage on this stage. Being a full bike park run, I believe I could do really well. I just can't do anything stupid. I just gotta relax right now and just breathe.
Me and all the guys pretty much all collectively said, Jordan can win this if he doesn't send it too hard.
I like the confidence. I like the, so. Thank you.
This is exciting. It's like the perfect conditions.
Hi, Paul.
Hello, Nick.
Josh, stop it.
Sorry.
Hello, friends.
So for stage one, we were all given a specific starting order based on our plate numbers, of course. Starting with me, and then VanCan, Paul the Punter, Daily Mountain Bike Rider, Lone Ranger, BCPOV, and then last but not least, BKXC.
Hey, Jordan.
Yeah, yeah. Fist bumps, Nick.
Sitting here now, on the top of the world, all the stress of the morning has gone away. I'm actually feeling really good about this.
5, 4, 3.
Okay. Oh boy, let's give a pedal there. Oh my goodness, I gotta last for like 25 minutes. Let's not go too crazy here, because honestly there's not that much ground I can gain from them. But so far, you know what, I'm feeling good. Actually feeling quite good. Just keep calm. We're just riding some trails. Maybe a little bit faster than normal, but whew! So it seems I'm kind of catching up to this guy pretty quick here. That's awkward. Thanks.
There are many people who've made their predictions as to how they think all of us will place in this race. I've also made my own predictions, and I'm going to reveal that at the end of this video. But otherwise, we've got all day tomorrow to see who the real winner is, and that's going to be featured in my next video, of course. But today will be a good starting point to see how we compare to each other. Now, with this top of the world trail specifically, I don't think there's going to be too much difference between us. So what that means is I shouldn't start to push myself too hard on this stage, because otherwise I won't have as much energy to really do well on the later part of the stage, which is where I think I can really shine.
Pedal, pedal. This is where they can gain ground on me. I'm not gonna let them. Not gonna let them catch up to me. And rest time. So I'm getting kind of tired.
So for those of you who don't know how this whole enduro race thing works, because I certainly didn't before this year, they reveal the course only a few days or a week before the race happens. So for this race, they finally revealed the course on the Saturday before, so 1 week earlier. And on top of that, they said that you're not allowed to ride any of the trails, so how am I supposed to practice now? Well, they give you the Thursday and Friday right before the race as practice days. Now, I'm not very interested in doing all kinds of practice right before the race because I always like a rest day beforehand. But I did go and got practice on the Thursday. I missed out on Friday's practice, so a couple stages tomorrow are going to be blind for me. But I got to practice on this stage as well as two others, which is really good for me to do, especially considering that this bike is new for me as of only 4 days before.
Man, it's so rough. Oh, that works, your arms and your legs.
The thing I needed to focus on was just staying calm, cool, and collected. Staying consistent, not doing anything stupid, just taking it easy and pacing myself throughout the race.
Okay, it gets better here. Oh, so rough. Sick.
The cool thing I realized while riding this top of the world stage is that even if I wanted to go full send on something, I actually couldn't because of fatigue. It was actually keeping me in check, which was a pretty good thing. Especially considering how rough top of the world is, you get that fatigue right away, and you don't even have a chance to do anything stupid anymore. I'm just basically holding on to as much comfort as I can, and just making my way down. So I'm not running cushcord in my tires right now. It's something that I'm interested in trying, but right as my bike is brand new, I didn't bother getting it just yet. So I figured to be a bit safer on this really rocky trail, I put my PSI up to 30 for both front and rear. I think it worked out fairly good for me. Plus, I figure, I mean, you can roll a bit faster anyway, so I figure that's a good thing too. I am gonna let out a little bit of air for day two though.
Oh, I'm riding so well. Oh, tiring on my hands the most. second would be my legs. Oh, it's a bit wet here. Rained a little. What a run. Go rest a bit. Wow, there's just like no resting. Wow. The front tire split out just a little, but that's okay. Oh, just gotta sit down and rest. Hands are the most tired. Ah, and that was bad. Almost there. Here we go. We're done. Done top of the world. What's going on? Oh. Here we go. Just can't get out of control. Sick. Beautiful. Okay, just going where I know, which is this way. It might not be the best way. Too bad. We're doing it. I'm happy with that. Okay. Oh, uphill. A little alder, this one's weird. Hey, don't go up the rock. Almost crashed during practice last time. Oh boy. And now we're going down. Too tight. Excellent. Oh, I'm feeling so composed. This is mint. Those bars, those trees. Okay. I'm getting tired. Yeah. Yeah, I'm getting tired. Getting really tired. Okay. I need a rest. This is a rest. Here's another rest. Double left. Actually, it's first part single left. That was perfect.
This right here is the scariest part of the whole course. Keep in mind, I've been riding for 23 minutes already, and now I have to go into some gnarly, double black, steep, rocky section. I actually don't even ride this section very often when I ride the bike park. I don't care if I do it the best. I'm just needing to survive and make it through the whole course without screwing up. And that basically was one of my main strategies, which is to kind of ride calmly. As long as I don't screw up, then I've got this. So far, I think it's working out for me, but we'll see how the results are, and we'll also see how tomorrow goes too.
Rider! Thanks, dude. Almost done. I'm riding amazing. Thank you, Jesus. Woo! This is epic.
So I got a time of 24:53, which puts me at 59th place out of the whole EWS 100 men category. But I don't think you guys care too much about those standings. We just want to see who wins out of the YouTubers, so let's wait for the other guys to finish and see how we do. Looks like Nick Van Can crosses the line at 26:23. Oh, but Josh just came in, looks like he got 25:31. That's a good time.
Oh, Paul's across the line.
Looks like Paul the punter crossed the line soon after with a time of 26:16. That puts him right in front of Van Can, but a good distance behind me and Daily Mountain Bike Rider.
Yeah, Eric! Yeah, Eric! Woo!
Ah, BCPOV, a crowd favorite, has just crossed the line. Coming in ahead of Paul the Punter, 25:56.
Everything else.
Aha, BKXC comes in. Oh, just beating BCPOV, 25:50. Well, look at this. We're just waiting for the Lone Ranger right now.
Oh, yeah.
Not the rocks, the woods.
All those, like, firm switchbacks and stuff. Yeah.
It wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be, though.
Yeah.
Like,
it was steadily hurting for me a good amount.
Jamie, what?
Ryan just crosses the line. 27:21. So that doesn't change the standings at all. So he's going to take the rear on this one. Well, would you look at that? I got to say, I was not quite expecting Daily Mountain Bike Rider to get second. And I think he surprised a lot of us.
I had near flawless, except for no joke. He went nose heavy, went off the next jump, even more. I almost died.
Sometimes when I've ridden with Josh, he has impressed me. Like when he rode his hardtail at Whistler, riding all of Goat's Gully on a hardtail. He actually is a pretty strong rider, and I think that a lot of us are underestimating him. Well, that feels good to get first, and to have a 38-second lead over second place is a nice place to be. So who did I actually predict to win this race? Now keep in mind, my predictions are for the full 2 days, not just from day one. But my predictions were that I would take first, BCPOV second, BKXC third, Van Can would be fourth, Daily Mountain Bike Rider fifth, Paul the Punter sixth, and seventh would be Lone Ranger. I did think BCPOV would have gotten better on this stage, but he did say his hands were hurting a lot and he was just riding it rather than racing it.
That was it.
Good, my hands were a little sore, but it wasn't so bad.
Yeah.
I kind of just more rode it than raced it.
Oh, yeah.
What'd
you get? Playing kind of safe or whatever.
25:56.
You won a little crash?
Oh, nice.
Okay, so you did that show to get a little wet up there then?
25:50.
Sweet.
Oh, yeah, you beat me.
That's cool.
But he had a chain drop.
I lost
what?
Oh, yo. Oh, dude.
What'd you get?
A chain drop.
Okay.
Big clickbait.
Yeah.
I had a perfect run.
Sounds like we got it was flawless. Here for this next athlete.
Dude, it was crazy. I got rid of all my like janky like crashing on practice days.
There you go. Yeah.
I went the wrong way like 2 times. It was terrible.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, like, I wasn't expecting you to get second on that. That's sick.
I wasn't either.
That's sick, dude.
If this guy didn't drop his chain, I have a feeling you would have beat
him. Yeah, I think so too.
You lost like 20 seconds, you figured?
Yeah.
Yeah, I wonder if BKXC could have beat Daily Mountain Bike Rider or maybe even tied him if he didn't lose his chain. But you know what? That's racing. And the thing is, we've got a whole big day tomorrow coming up, with about 35 to 40 minutes worth of racing to do. There's a lot of room for people to improve their rankings and screw up their rankings. Man, for a day that started out so stressful and just not fun at all, it has turned around quite well for me. This is probably the best part about racing, is once it's done, hanging out with the crew, talking about our runs, definitely a great time. Stay tuned for my next video. We're gonna see how this concludes. And yeah, it gets a bit messy. Not just because of the weather. Thank you all for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this. Please give a like and subscribe. Consider supporting me on Patreon. Patrons are a huge help in me being full-time and an independent mountain bike creator. Big thanks to all of them. And I will see you guys next time.
You knew really well. Yeah, it turned out they'll be
smile. You're on camera. Sweet, dude.